I got Gordon Lightfoot with me today, as always. Keep him in here, right next to Parliament Funkadelic. Yeah, a lot of obituaries this week, more than I can actually do today, because there was a few others that I'm probably going to do like aside videos about. But yeah, Gordon Lightfoot hit me pretty hard. It's interesting. I've thought a lot about this because, at least here in Philly, of course, as people know, I listen to WPRB. It's playing in the lab all day, and there's just been a gush of tributes for Gordon Lightfoot this week. Just about every show has done sets of Gordon Lightfoot material, and it led me to really realize that the people who are really sad about Gordon Lightfoot passing are not so much people of my parents' generation, whom were the target for his music originally. It was supposed to be like the baby boomers were supposed to be into Gordon Lightfoot. That's who the music was marketed to. But I think it was really the Gen Xers, the people of my generation, who as very young kids were exposed to Gordon Lightfoot on FM radio. And I think we have the most nostalgia for it, because in those days, in the early 70s, you'd be in the car, and If You Could Read My Mind would come on the radio, and as a child, you would just become immersed in the visual imagery, the sort of like gothic or medieval wordplay, and it's kind of like the first time that I heard Someone Save My Life Tonight on the radio. I was just like, all I could do for days was think about these images that were evoked by this song. And Gordon Lightfoot did that a lot with his songs. Very visual, told a story. So I think it's actually like people of my generation that are really mourning the loss of Gordon Lightfoot, because it is something that harkens back to our early childhood. Hearing him on the radio, hearing his voice and those words that he used, those words that for, you know, as a kid, a lot of those words and phrases you're hearing for the first time. but yeah, listening to Gordon a lot this week and being very sad. And of course, all the obits of Gordon Lightfoot, Gordon. But I mean, really just so, I mean, you don't have to sell that. You know, so many records were sold just because women would, you know, be passing a record store and say, oh, I want that. Yeah, I want that big time. So smoldery. Gordon, he was man handsome. You know? Very man handsome. Women wanted to have him, men wanted to be him. Like Canadian roughness, like a unknowable wild. In the lab.
That's where I work. In the lab. Go berserk. At the bench. fun. I'm Fran.